Most of you believe that the two witnesses are going to physically lie dead on the streets of Jerusalem for 3.5 days. You got this false belief from the teachings and the translations of deceived men. And Hollywood has even depicted this to be the case. You buy into what Hollywood leads you to believe. The revelations of our Messiah that Yahweh's messenger gave to the Apostle John are a prophecy. They are written prophetically. And this prophecy was sealed until the time of the end. Some of it is still sealed at this time. That which is still sealed will be manifested in the coming 67 days. Today, November 14th on Satan's calendar, is the first day of the ninth month on our Creator's restored calendar. Today we are 60 days out from the beginning of the great and the fearful day of His wrath that will last for 7 days. I will share with you today what the Most High has revealed about His two witnesses lying dead on the streets of Jerusalem. In Revelation 11, we're told, His dead body, or that which is fallen, and is referring to singular here in the Greek, will be upon the street, or upon the wide pathway of the great city, spiritually, meaning not physically, which is called Sodom in Egypt, and where, referring to Jerusalem, our Messiah was impaled on the stake. This verse says that that one of Yahweh's two witnesses is going to be perceived dead by those of you who are on the wide pathway, and it ties in the wide pathway with Jerusalem, not physically Jerusalem, but rather the great city that is likened to Sodom in Egypt. Yahweh has manifested the prophecies that are recorded in His word to us in a way that has testified that this is the United States, the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel at this time. This verse also says that the other witness is going to be dead in the city where Yeshua was killed. Keep in mind that it was sealed until the testimony of His word that the Most High has sent me with, that Yeshua was the first witness. In verse 9, and the people from the tribes and the heathens and the different languages will see or will perceive His dead body, again, singular in the Greek, that which has fallen for 3.5 days. And their dead bodies, that which they perceived to be fallen, and now it's plural in the Greek, will not be left laid in the tomb. Yahweh's word clearly testifies to the identity of His two witnesses. The time of day that Yeshua was killed on the 14th day of the first month, along with the time of day that we are supposed to kill the Passover lambs or goats on the same day, along with other prophecies, established that Yeshua was dead for 3.5 days. He was in the tomb for 3 days and 3 nights, but He was dead in Jerusalem for 3.5 days, or for 84 hours, since He told us that there are 12 hours in a day. And Yahweh did not allow His body to remain in the tomb. Zechariah recorded that the two witnesses are Yahweh's two anointed sons, His two olive trees that stand on each side of the golden candlestick. Zechariah identified them by name, Yeshua and Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel means one who would flow out from the captivity. John also recorded that Yahweh's two witnesses that are His two olive trees stand on each side of the golden candlestick. Zechariah recorded that the golden oil flows out through them. The revelations of our Messiah that were given to John tell us that this golden oil is Yahweh's seven spirits. There are only two people who the scriptures record that this golden oil flows out through, Yeshua and Zerubbabel. The Apostle John recorded that the two witnesses are in possession of the reed that the temple was measured with. Yahweh's servant Zechariah recorded that this reed or this measuring line was given into the hand of Zerubbabel. Yahweh's temple was built with His word. His word is the measuring line that all will be judged by. There are two people who have been sent to testify to this, Yeshua and Zerubbabel. Yahweh's servant John said that the two witnesses would turn the water into blood. This was done through Yahweh's sacrifice of His only begotten son, Yeshua, on the stake, and His end-time messenger of His covenant, Michael, that He has plucked out from the captivity that His word also calls by the name Zerubbabel. Zechariah recorded that Yeshua entered into Zerubbabel to become the final stone of Yahweh's temple. As far as my death goes, those of you who are on the broad path perceived my testimony to be dead. You perceive the testimony of the 84 days that the sign of Jonas testifies to as being dead. Your problem is, the testimony that I have been sent with is not my testimony. It is the testimony of the Most High's word. It is His testimony. And I can assure you that the testimony of His word is not dead. He has manifested to us several tiers of 84 days in His timeline. He has woven some of these tears into the restored timing of his appointed times, and he has shown that the silence in heaven prophecy that is found in Revelation 8:1 for the space of a half an hour is for 84 days. Yahweh has revealed another tier of 84 days that began on the 24th day of the 6th month and ends on the 17th day of the 9th month on his restored calendar. The 24th day of the 6th month is the day that he gave his servant Haggai his prophecy for Zerubbabel and Yeshua for doing work on his house. And on the 17th day of the 9th month, we will be 51 days out from the end of the great and the fearful day of his wrath. I've expanded on the significance of 51 days in several recent videos and how it ties in with Yahweh's Elijah prophecy. The 51 day mark will be on November 30th on the calendar that Satan gave his subjects to use. Will this be the last tier of the silence from heaven for the space of a half an hour? We will soon find out. I'll share with you another tier of 84 days. In all of the tiers of 84 days, the count includes the first day and the last day. This is because the 84 hours that Yeshua was dead includes the first hour and the last hour that he was dead. 84 days prior to the end of the great and the fearful day of Yahweh's wrath was the 15th day of the 8th month on Yahweh's restored calendar. The 15th day of the 8th month was the first day of Jeroboam's profaned feast that he instituted. Jeroboam caused the 10 tribes of Israel that were given under his rule to sin a great sin against the Most High in altering his appointed times. You think that you can serve him whenever and however you like to, just like Jeroboam did, and our descendants did back then. You are soon going to find out differently. In verse 10, and those who dwell upon the earth will be happy upon them, or upon that which you think has fallen, and they will rejoice and send gifts to one another, because these two prophets vexed those who dwelled upon the earth. You are happy that the abomination of desolation, Saul of Tarsus, brought you his more excellent pathway, so that you could follow him instead of following the Most High's only begotten Son, who told us that we must live by every word that his Father spoke. You rejoice that the testimony of Yahweh's word that was recorded by his servants the prophets appears to be dead. Like I said, I can assure you that it is not dead. It accomplished that which he sent it down from heaven to accomplish. It accomplished building his temple. You rejoice in your false salvation doctrines. You are happy to send gifts to one another on the horse blasphemous celebration on December 25th. You are happy to celebrate times like birthdays and send one another gifts on them in spite of Yahweh's word commanding us not to celebrate them. I have been sent to you speaking the same words that our Messiah spoke about obeying his Father, and you despise me for it. This shows that you despise that which he spoke. Therefore, you despise him. You despise his true character. His true character is the image of his Father's word. Yeshua called the religious hypocrites liars and snakes and vipers and hypocrites. And our ancestors were happy to kill him for doing so. They rejoiced in that which they believed had fallen when they killed him. And the same is true with me. You rejoice in the apparent fallen testimony of the Most High's word that he has sent me to you with. I have bad news for you. In verse 11, and after 3 1/2 days, or after 84 hours, or 84 days, the spirit of life from Yahweh Elohim entered into them, and they stood upon their feet, and great fear fell upon those who saw them. Yahweh's word told us through his servant Zechariah to rejoice when you see the measuring rod given into his servant Zerubbabel's hand. Instead, you rejoice that the testimony of his word that he has sent me with appears to be dead. Yahweh rose up Yeshua after 3 1/2 days. A third of the world believes this sign, yet you still will not follow him, walking as he walked in his Father's word. Yahweh is going to raise me up before your face after his final tier of 84 days of silence from heaven, and he is going to pull up your skirts and uncover the shame of your nakedness. He is going to show you that you are bald and uncovered before his face. Like I said, will this be on November 30th? Will it be 84 hours later? I do not know. But I do know that the testimony of Yahweh Elohim's word says that you are going to know that he has sent me to you. And he is going to exalt his righteousness in judgment. He is going to judge you with his word that you refuse to hearken to. He's going to judge you with his word that you refuse to return to him through that which he has restored. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim.